Hi, I'm Carmen and welcome to the Featherweight Shop. There are all kinds of featherweight attachments that can handle any number of sewing tasks. Now, to secure many of these attachments to the featherweight, Singer machined two threaded holes directly into the bed of the featherweight, just right here to the right of the needle. Many of these attachments use these threaded holes, like the Amoeba feed cover plate. It's used for free motion and embroidery work. Also the feed dog cover plate for the buttonholer. Even the vintage original underbraider uses those holes as well. And our popular Featherweight Accurate Seam Guide. Now sometimes you can experience trouble securing an attachment when the screw won't screw all the way down into the bed of the machine. You can quickly and easily check the threads by using the thumb screw from your presser bar, since the screw and these mid-bed holes have the exact same threads. Most of the time, the featherweight screw will turn down easily and securely all the way to the top of the bed. But occasionally, the screw gets stuck or it won't screw down all the way. This can happen for a number of reasons. There can be crystallized or varnished oil down in the threads, and that stops the screw and needs to be cleaned out. A more serious problem, however, can be that the threads themselves are actually damaged and they have to be fixed. Now, we have a fairly easy way to help you do this yourself, but first let's clean out the thread holes. You can easily clean the threads by applying a few drops of kerosene in the holes, and this will help soften and dissolve any old varnished oil that might be inside those tiny threads. The holes are open all the way to the bottom, which helps drain away any excess kerosene, along with the dissolved oil and grime. Now gently thread the featherweight thumb screw back into the hole, and usually after one or two applications of kerosene, this will completely clean out those threaded holes. Sometimes, however, the threads themselves may have actually been damaged at some point in the past. And if after several attempts to clean out those holes, the screw does still not easily turn all the way down, you may need to retrue those threads back to their original condition. To retrue the threads, we've developed a featherweight retruing tap that exactly matches the original Singer featherweight thread pitch on those holes. The machining world has literally hundreds of different thread pitches for different screws. And for the featherweight and many other Singer models, Singer used a fairly unique thread pitch. Nothing common that you will find in the US, which means you can't just run down to the hardware store and buy a replacement screw. The featherweight screw pitches are pretty uncommon and unique. Sometimes people will find a screw from their local hardware store that looks like a close fit. And because your featherweight is made of cast aluminum, which is a relatively soft metal, by forcing these misfitting screws down into the featherweight, people can end up stripping and ruining the threads. The good news is you can now easily retrue those threads. Our retruing tap not only has the exact Singer thread pitch and angle, but there's also an all-important cutting edge milled into the tap that retrues the original threads as you screw it down into the hole. If your threads are in good shape, then the tap will simply follow the threads down with no resistance. But if they are damaged, the tap will restore the threads to their original pitch. Simply start the tap into the mid-bed hole like you would any screw, and when you start to experience resistance, place the handle into the head of the tap and gently but firmly screw the tap all the way into the hole. This cuts and cleans away any crossed or damaged threads, any crystallized oil or grime, and restores the correct thread pitch. As soon as the tap is all the way down, back it out and clean the hole in the tap with a little kerosene. Your featherweight screw should now easily turn all the way down to the surface of the bed. But what if the screw that came with your attachment is actually the damaged part? You can test this by removing your presser foot thumb screw and try gently threading your attachment screw into the empty presser foot hole. As we said, these have the exact same featherweight pitch. And if it doesn't easily and smoothly turn in, you should probably replace the screw. And replacements are available on the website. If you have any further problems, questions on cleaning or repairing your mid-bed threaded holes or any other featherweight issue, just give us a call. We'll be happy to help. Have a great day.